topic which we are going to discuss is the uncertainty principle. So this is the famous Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. According to this principle, it's impossible to measure simultaneously and precisely both the position and the momentum of the particle. So it means the uncertainty in position and the uncertainty in the momentum. In other words, it may be said that the product of the uncertainty and in position and the uncertainty in the momentum is always greater than h cut. H cut is the basic constant, more basic constant as compared to the h. H cut is equal to h by 2 pi. So this relation was given by Heisenberg, and this is known as the Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. So here it states that if we try to measure the position and momentum of the particle at the same time, simultaneously, at that time the product could not be less than the h cut value. So delta px would be always greater than h cut by delta x, while delta x would be always greater than h cut by delta px. So if you know the position of the particle, so it means there is no change in the position of the particle. So it means delta x is equal to 0. The particle is completely localized. So if delta x is equal to 0, at that time if we will fill here the value of delta x, delta px would be infinite, in fact more than infinite. So it means that momentum of the particle is completely unknown. So on the other hand, if delta px is equal to 0, then delta x is equal to 0. So it means the particle is completely unlocalized and the particle is spreading all over the space. So a precise knowledge of x or px can be obtained only at the expense of the precision of the other. So if px is known, x would not be known. If x is known, px would not be known. So in case of the other three other dimensions, we can write delta y, delta py, product of these two terms, and in case of z axis, delta z, delta pz. So this we can write. These uncertainties, they are not due to any technical problem. These are inherent in the very nature of things. So in actual experiment which is performed in laboratory, there will arise experimental errors in addition to these uncertainties. So even if the experimental errors are reduced to zero, even if we consider that experimental errors are zero and we are not considering those, even then wave particle duality would remain, and these errors, these uncertainties would always be there. So what are the consequences of this uncertainty principle? What would change if we see that delta x and delta px product is always greater than h cut? So in classical mechanics, Newton's laws describe the motion of the particle. So from these laws, it is possible to obtain the values of position and momentum at any time. Okay, but what should we know is the position and the momentum of the particle at a certain time t is equal to zero, and the forces which are acting on the particle. So it means the path of the particle can be determined very easily. So these statements, the Newton's laws, these statements hold true for the objects which are having large size, which are having macroscopic size. So the uncertainty principle say that position and momentum of the particle, the particle of atomic dimensions only. Okay, so this is all about the atomic dimensions particles. So there is also another point, that uncertainty principle puts no restriction to the accuracy to which x and px can be individually measured. So it will restrict only on the simultaneous measurements. Okay, so when we are measuring at the same time, at that time delta x delta p product would be always greater than h cut. So this is what now we are going to derive in next article. So this is named as derivation of expression of Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. This we all know, psi x, which we have derived earlier. So at t is equal to 0, the wave function has this value, the maximum value. So this is what we have, t is equal to 0. So we are having delta kx divided by x. This is the value we have. And the amplitude is known, is obtained by omitting this exponential part, and we are having 2 sine delta kx by x. This is the amplitude of this wave packet. So when I am moving towards the position uncertainty, so this is what I am having. So the position uncertainty, the particle is most likely to have to be found in the region from here to here. So it means minus pi by delta x to pi by delta x. Okay, so delta x would be x2 minus x1, which is pi by delta k minus minus pi by delta k, which is 2 pi by delta k. So this is what I have with 2 pi by delta k. Now moving towards the momentum uncertainty. Okay, so p1 would be equal to h cut k naught minus delta k to h cut k naught plus delta k. So this is the momentum uncertainty. So uncertainty means I am just subtracting the both these two momentums. So p2 minus p1 it would give me 2 h cut by delta k. So this is my delta p and this is delta x. So when I'm going to multiply these both, delta x into delta p, so I will have 2 pi by delta k into 2 h cut delta k. So this will give me 2 h. So now we have derived Heisenberg's delta x into delta p is 2h. Now I have derived Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. This is with reference to one specific wave packet which we have derived earlier, the wave packet duality which we have considered earlier. So in the next chapter we will be discussing the more general result. Okay, so this is all about the Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. Today we have derived this. So tomorrow we will be discussing about the applications of the uncertainty principle.